All right, y'all, welcome back. Fourth grade astronomy, here we are making a comet. Now, this is not part of our official standards. This is really just more cool, fun, interesting, and building up your awesome science street cred. In this case, we're building a comet out of some dry ice and some other materials. First of all, if you've never dealt with dry ice, it is carbon dioxide that has been frozen, essentially. It's about negative 70 degrees Fahrenheit. It's very cold. If you pick it up with your fingers after a couple seconds, it will start to burn your skin. So don't do that. This is not something that the kids can have any access to without supervision. You really don't want them touching it. Some people have videos where they try to put this in their mouth and then it will burn your tongue. It'll stick to your tongue, first of all, and then it'll start to burn. And then as they try to get it out, it'll peel off the skin from the inside out. That's not where you want to be. So it is a safety issue in terms of not letting the kids touch it. But there are a wide variety of things you can do with it in the classroom, and it's fairly readily available. I bought this from Publix, and it's usually about $10 a pound. So if you were doing this for a variety of classes all at once, or needed it for the whole day, the way to store this is in a styrofoam container with a bunch of newspaper around it to kind of help keep it insulated. A blanket works well too. But do not put it in a sealed container, like a igloo that has a tight fitting lid, because as this dry ice gets warm, it sublimates, which means it turns from a solid straight into a gas. And that gas pressure will build up. And it will either it'll pop the lid or crack something, and that's not where you want to be. So a loose-fitting styrofoam cooler works best. A blanket wrapped around it will help it stay for part of the day. It's really not going to last more than a day, though. So if you think you're going to buy some for the week or whatever, it's not going to work that way. So what I need to do is I'm going to use some leather gloves, and I'm going to use some rubber gloves. I'm going to put my safety goggles on first because dry ice in the eye will be very bad. Now I'm using leather gloves underneath my rubber gloves because while I'm going to get wet, the rubber gloves by themselves will not really offer me enough insulation to work with the dry ice. But if I do this, I'm bet. Okay, I'm good. So I'm going to pick some dry ice. So frozen carbon dioxide and a big chunk of the hammer. Break it up a little bit. I need to be able to have it in smaller pieces so that I can mix it up with the water. Now you can see all this condensation coming out. Not condensation as much, but it's changing the moisture in the air to a fog. I just need to break it into smaller pieces. Just using a hammer in my hand. You can use a table, I guess. Okay. Again, so you're doing this, the kids are not right around you because they will inevitably reach in and try to grab stuff. When you've made it, you will go back to the kids and you'll be able to show them what it looks like. And I'll show you, of course, you're doing it. Okay, now, you can hear the carbon dioxide. It's chilling this bowl. Okay, you can see the frost layer on the bottom, okay? Now I'm going to add a little water to this. I'm going to add some ammonia in the form of Windex. Not too much. Come on. My Windex bottle is improving. There we go. Just a couple squirts. And I'm going to put in some organic material, in this case some soil. You can add some soy sauce or some Worcestershire sauce if you want, but definitely put some soil in it. I'm going to mix it all in. Now this looks really cool. But as a visual, we've got a bowl full of stuff. So now I'm just going to mix this up with my hands. You can use a pair of tongs or whatever if you want. I'm trying to get the water cold, and I want to get the dirt and the ammonia mixed in. And I'm trying to build basically a giant, dirty snowball. Try to hold together until it freezes. This is why you need the leather gloves underneath the rubber gloves, because if I did this with just rubber gloves, my hands would be very upset. Could you get me a little more water? Mm-hmm. need a little bit of water here. Because the dry ice won't stick together, but if I have to put a little more water in here, it'll help the dry ice adhere to each other, and that's what we need to kind of make this happen. But you can still hear it going. Thank you so much. It's not going to be a beautiful thing when you're done, trust me, but it doesn't have to be beautiful. Of the extreme version. So what you've got is dirt stuck together with water that's frozen, and you've got carbon dioxide that's sublimating the gas. Now, the sublimation of the carbon dioxide, this is why the comets have a tail. It's because the dry ice is sublimating from the power of the sun as it revolves around it. But if you listen to this, I don't know if you can hear that, this will do all kinds of things. You'll have little bursts of trapped CO2 water vapor coming out. You'll have, it'll crack suddenly for no reason. It will, it'll sound like Rice Krispie treats. Like it sounds like it's alive because it's all cracking and doing different things as you bring this around. Now again, I have leather gloves under the rubber gloves, which is why I can hold it in my hand like this and not be hurt. Don't just use rubber gloves when you do this. So that's what you make comment. This is the part that you can take around with the kids. Now, they still shouldn't be touching this, but they can see this. This is probably a little dirtier than what you would want, so if you use a little more water, a little more dry ice, you can make a larger ball, and it will look a little bit more like what they pictured as a comet. But this is what a comet is, basically a giant, dirty snowball. Made of dry ice, water vapor, and some soil. And this is one of the ways we think that the reason why we have oceans on our planet is because enough comets hit our planet in its early history that their moisture was then added to our planet's atmosphere, essentially, which then rained down and became part of our oceans. So, three things mixed together. Dry ice, water, some ammonia, and then just a little bit of organic material in terms of soil, soy sauce, or whatever. And that makes your comet that your kids can then look at and hear and work with. Again, have them draw pictures, have them talk about it, have them write about it, and then when you send home, pictures are great. That way you can send pictures home with the kids through Seesaw, some other online medium, and that way the kids can point to that and can explain what they did in class with you. If the kids are looking at this, by the way, they should have goggles on as well, just because you don't want them to get too close. Sometimes these things, the dry ice cracks a little bit, and so you just want to make sure that everyone's eyes are protected. So, that's how to make a comet. Thanks so much.